praises and honor and glory to Yahweh, Vashem, Yahushai, Vashem, Kakodash, double honor to the elders and the apostles of great men to go well. Salutation to the Achaeans, Bushanish, truth, insincerity to the four corners of the earth, to the one who acquires who listen and learn, being obedient to the husband, the brother Howard, from the GMS, prophetic vibration, came back on another lesson to the spirit and power of Vashem, which is your Kakodash. You know, so today's topic, you know, as I was trolling, you know, my morning walk, you know, down, you know, on the work side, you know, the fear of the Lord come upon me because, you know, late last night, you know, the neighbor died from C19, you know, but the angel said that she take the jab, you know, when she went in the hospital and, you know, she died instantly. So we didn't win everything, you know, pertaining to the C19. And Esau, you know, just hitting you that kill shot just to pull you out, to out your life. So as you come in with any set kind of symptoms, you know, is a kill shot one time to finish you out, you know. So as a man of the Lord, you know, you just seeing that how the Lord, you know, just praying to that someone right next to you, you know, someone right next to you, you know, she'll just put her there just so. You know, so you had to fear the Lord knowing that He covered you. You know, He covered you. He keeping you safe, you know. He protecting you from the destruction will come in. You know, so I'll go in the scripture in Psalms chapter 35, verse 9. It says, "Oh, fear Yahweh, ye His saints, for there is no want to them that fear Him." So, hey, so that you write about it because you want in things that is good, but plagues are upon you right now. So if you wanting in anything in the world, hey, it's just you wanting destruction because the Lord is coming to destroy everything. You know why the Lord said God have no treasures in his life, you know, because the Lord coming to destroy you. Even when he say in Psalms, you know, it can deliver you or save you when times of trouble come. So that why, you know, why you have any fear for your heart, Hashem and Shai, you know, as Colossians 3 and 1 say, stay affliction and things above. So you're more focusing on the kingdom of heaven than the wanting of things on this earth. The most thing you might want in this kingdom is to let this kingdom fall. And that's the one thing you had to have, hastily coming of Yahweh Hashem and Shai. That's the want. Hastily coming of the Lord and you know, praying for Babylon to fall. You know, that is his spirit. You know, because as we know, we're heading into some serious times. We're farming. You know, farming, you know, physical farming with food and spiritual farming is coming, you know, and we see in World War III amping up, you know, it could take place anytime, could break, all hell could break loose in any minute, any hour. So, as the scripture says, we don't know what kind of person we are to be, I come in at the Lord in conversation and everything. So, that's why we had to be checking myself, we had to be checking myself daily. You know, because Yahweh Hashem and Shai have his angels, you know, taking their report. So we had to be in that spiritual mindset, you know, and in these last time, hey, pushing his truth and you know, continue that brotherly love, you know, pushing it. You know, if you're slacking, if you're slacking and you ain't giving it your all, give it your all, because we're in a time where you had to be giving your all. So when the Lord come, you can get delivered, he could give you that grace which we're coming with. There's a serious time coming. So we praying for the Yamashiach to come, but when he come, you gotta make sure that you put in your works, you know? And pray that he bring grace on your side, that you are part of the hopefully left. So we got scripture here in Psalms 115, verse 11. It says, "He that fear Yahweh, trust in Yahweh." It says he is their help and their shield. So we know that Yahweh Hashem and Shai, once we fear him, he's our help. You know, because he doesn't have the blueprint. So when we're going through our trials, like Yahweh Hashem and Shai, directing our footsteps, even if they pull us to the synagogues to slaughter us, we know that that is our part of our mission, that is a part of our role to play. You know, that is our role, you know, in the mission to get to be a matter for Yahweh Hashem and Shai. So all praises, you know, we had to know that Yahweh Hashem and Shai, you know, to be that shield, even if we're going through that hour, you know, if he, you know, give you that spiritual power, you know, to heal, to run fast, whatever it is, we knowing that he's our shield, he's our helper, He gave us that spiritual power to you know, to go through every and any situation. And that is the spirit that Yahweh Hashem Roshai, we would have any fear. You know, the spirit that he put on us, you know, to have no fear, you know, have no fear. As I say in the scripture, you know, I just mark along everything in, you know, in the bookmark. You know? Yeah, let's see. Behold, the eye of Yahweh is upon them that fear him, upon them that hope in his mercy. So it says that behold, the eyes of Yahweh is upon them that fear him. So all who fear Yahweh, his eyes always on you. Yahweh, his eyes always on you. He always ready, you know, to deliver you from any, you know, terror, any destruction, any troubles. You know, the Lord always there for you. Even when you're going through your fiery trials, he are there with you because his eyes are upon you. You know, his angels, his eyes always upon you. It say upon them that hope in his mercy. So we have hope. We have a sure hope in his truth until the end. Because that's the only way we could see ourselves out of this wicked queendom. You know, having the hope and mercy unto Yahweh Hashem Roshai. It say to deliver their soul from death. So who can deliver our soul from death? Yahweh Hashem Roshai, which we know the second death is a nuclear turmoil, nuclear fire, which is coming to which is going to be the Lord's vengeance upon the face of the earth. You know, to burn the earth straight to smithereens. You know, especially Esau, Edom, to cleanse out his queendom. You know, because as the scripture say, you know, the ones who come and shed, you know, the innocent blood, is their blood we're going to shed on the face of the earth in the cleanse back the earth, the blood of the wicked. So the blood of the wicked will cleanse the earth when you have Hashem Roshai, you know, set a slaughter from our side, set a poor all to death, you know, put them to death. Because why? You know, they touch the Lord's apple of his eye, you know, the nation of Israel. And say, and to keep them alive in famine. Yes, and so Yahweh Hashem Roshai, he will deliver our souls and keep we from farming, keep us alive. So when all hells are the break loose, we knowing that Yahweh Hashem Roshai will feed us. We had a story about growing no kush, we had a story about digging up in no cupboard. Yahweh Hashem Roshai will feed us. You know, as it say in the scripture in Jeremiah 15 and 11, it said, the Lord said, verily, it shall be well with thy remnant. And that remnant go back to the elect. You know, the ones who the Lord said he wouldn't feed. You know, it said, verily, I will cause the enemy to entreat thee well in the time of evil. So that time of evil going back into Jacob's trouble. You know, and our enemy going back in even to these two-thirds. Because why? They sign a covenant with death. They gonna choose the system rather than Yahweh Hashem Roshai. So they become our enemies because they are the Lord's enemy. You know, they go down into Egypt. They never require Yahweh Hashem Roshai, neither the prophets. Well, really the prophets, because Yahweh Hashem Roshai is in the prophets as his mouthpiece, you know, and to answer all the questions. That way Lord said be ready to answer all questions. You know, so you're ready to answer all these two questions, but they ain't gonna come on and require. Let's say, and in the time of affliction, so in the time of our affliction, Yahweh Hashem will feed us, you know. Yahweh Hashem, shall I say, he will feed us, you know, as it say, going down, it say, to deliver, in Psalms 33, verse 19, it say, to deliver their soul from death, and to keep them alive in famine. So the Lord going to make our enemies, as it say in Jeremiah, as it say in Jeremiah 15, verse 11, make our enemy to entreat us, you know, to feed us, you know. So even your mother should take the jab, or your ex-girlfriend, or your cousin, or your sister, whoever it is, or even your neighbor, you know, to the jab, you know, they will, the Lord will use their, you pass spirit on them to come and give you food, come and feed you, you know, because they have a shame in their face, because everything you tell them is coming to pass. Everything you tell them, you know, as you see today in this time, we prophesied and prophesied, all the problem we prophesied is coming to pass, because we did warn you in Sabah and in Maloney and Narima, in all the little small, you know, little small country, little small cities. You know, we went in these small cities, Kuva, Shibonas, wherever it is, you know, and we warn you, but you never hearken, you never take heed, you know, you never take heed, and bam, what you go on, you see 19 touchdown, and everybody just wearing masks now. So there's a big, I told you so, and it's a new plague will come in just now, as it's still breaking into to 2022. The Lord has have a lot of things tough for the wicked. So going down into 20, verse 20, it says, our soul waited for Yahweh, he is our help and our shield. So we're waiting for Yahweh, Shai. And I see the main point, waiting. You know, we are being a spirit of patience, we are being a spirit of waiting on the Yahweh, and paying matters in your own hands. Because anytime you put matters in your own hands, that means you have no patience, that means you really have fear the Lord. Because what should we tell Peter? You know, until Peter really get a true understanding, the Lord is in control of all things, and the Lord actually make Peter to do that what he do. You know, to cut off our ears, and then the Lord give him that message. So we will get the understanding, we will get the true message. We can't do poor actions in our own hands. We have to wait on the Mashiach. So all these wicked camp like Sakari and all these men and who will fire the gun range and feel that, you know, they can take matters in their own hand. The Lord will take the sword and put them to death, will destroy them. You know, it's say for our heart shall rejoice in him, because we have trust in his holy name. So as it's saying in Proverbs, you know, we the name of the Lord, we run towards it. It is a that's just a paraphrasing, you know, it is a shield, you know, it's a safety, you know, when we call upon your how about Shem and Shai, you know, running into that name, calling, you know, the true name. You know, we will get delivered. You know, you can call upon all these false, this false, you know, like the Buddha, the Allah, the all these gods have no power in their name. But how much only the elect will know in that time. You know, because as it's saying in Wisdom of Solomon 3:1. Bringing out verification sake, it says, but the souls of the righteous are in the hands of Yahweh, and there shall no torment touch them. So if you understand that all who fear Yahweh Hashem, you know, the Lord will be their shield, you know, and he will protect them, because their souls are in his hands, you know, he watching over them, you know. I want to go into the scripture in Proverbs, and I'll just show you precept upon precept. You know, when you go to Proverbs 10:3, it says Yahweh will not suffer the souls of the righteous to vanish, but he casted away the substance of the wicked. So the Lord will not let the souls of the righteous suffer. Even when they go down into Wisdom of Solomon, when they put us to death and thinking, you know, our life and going as misery, we had peace. We had peace with Yahmashiach. He don't pour in us. And at rest, you know, gain us that you know, extraterrestrial body, and we don't have only pony mindset. So we give him really body for the mindset, and that body going back into, you know, having that eternal life, because the spirit is done eternal life. Once you is that elect, you had a spirit, a eternal life in you. So once you know the truth, and you're going into the scriptures and all these things, and you know the breakdown in the true Lord name, and the Lord dealing with you, you know, you're going through your chastisements and all this stuff, you know, your temptations and all this stuff, and you know that the Lord delivering you, the Lord, you know, the Lord perfecting you for our rulership, you know. Just know that your spirit is immortality. Your spirit have that immortality in it, so you're just waiting for the body to complete, and I, the Lord coming with that completion, you know. So we knowing that we have any fear, he will protect us, he will keep us from farming, he can keep us from those who come against us. He will be our shield. He will be our buckler in the time of trouble. So just by, you know, getting up daily, you know, once you wake up in the morning, saying a prayer, having the fear, Yahweh Hashem Yahshai, knowing that, hey, you will be seeing death all around you. You will see death all around you. But just remember that the Lord protecting you. The souls of the righteous is in the Lord's hand. You know, the way the Lord says, He will not let, will not suffer the souls of the righteous in it to vanish. You know? So that's just show that the Lord is with you. The Lord will protect you. The Lord will guide you. Have any fear and doing the name of the Lord. You know? And doing His works. Being diligent, putting into His work. You know? So this is a short video. You know, truly power and spirit of Yahweh, you know, while I'm walking, you know. Say I will do a video because you had to be in a spirit of faith in the Lord. You know, being in the spirit of faith in the Lord and doing, you know, what He sent you to do, His mission. Because Yahweh came and He said, you know, he come to do what His Father sent Him to do. And when He went before when it was His hour, you know, and He was going through His hour, He said, don't let my will be done, but thy will be done. So that is spirit we had to be in all the time. Don't let our will be done with thy will, because if our will will be to our pleasure, to please us, to make us feel, don't feel that, you know, that tribulation to make us feel that fiery trial. But when Yahweh Bashem Rashai making us go through that to know how we will inherit the kingdom without going through the fire. You know, as it says in 2 Ezra, how we will actually, you know, go through it. If we go through all the hardship. All the tribulation, all the trial. How are we gonna come out perfect? How are we gonna know that the Lord went through? He went through just for us, so we had to go through. Because while we fall off, we transgress against the law, you know. So we had to go through that fiery trial. So that's why I said, let the will of Yahweh Bashem Yahshai be done. So we had to be in that spirit, letting the Lord, you know, try us, letting the Lord pour us away. If I had to be on the guillotine, if I had to be in eating for 2-3 days and the Lord feed you after, wherever it is, to see your family get, all the family get put to death and you alone, you know, survive it all, you know, to be delivered before, you know, by you seeing these nuclear fires coming down to destroy Babylon the Great, and at the same second a child delivering you and you seeing the destruction of Babylon the Great and seeing that you're getting delivered out of it, all these things, you know. It could be it could be in that spirit of rejoicing, a spirit of glad, a spirit of joyful to know the Lord deliver you. And the most important thing, the Lord will be, you know, happy seeing way that you fear Him and you continue in the faith, you continue pushing in the work, you complete your mission. You know, as the brother in London said, the Lord was clapping and jumping up for joy that He actually make it, as He say in His dream. So we had to be in that spirit of fearing the Lord and doing His will. You know, doing nothing that this will caught you up. You know, and they say we ain't gonna be in the want of any things. We ain't gonna be the want of any things that these wolves and destruction, women, work, wherever it is. You know, the Lord will provide for us. The Lord, you know, as it's saying in Jeremiah again, 59:11, we say our enemies will entreat us. So we will get feeding when famine come. We will get delivered when destruction come. Even if the Lord purpose to get put to death, don't even put your thoughts in your mind or words in your mouth, because the Lord will do that. So that will show the Lord always with you. The Lord always guiding you, protecting you, being that shield, being that protection. So you know, so just being in spirit, having the fear of the Lord, continuing in faith, you know, being meek, being humble, you know, doing the Lord's works. That's the most important, completing your mission, you know, which the Lord sent you to do. So I hope this video was edifying, you know. All praises to Yahweh, Bashem, Yahushai, Bashem, Rakakodash. Double honors to the elders and the apostles once again for of great millstone. We go well, salutation to the Achaeums, who pushing his truth to the Akwats, who be obedient to the husband, to the despicable Israelite. You know, hope this video edifying, you know, until the next one, Shalom.